Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar. Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan rasulullah. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
لا إله إلا الله رسول الله
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وسلم تسليما كثيرا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله فأحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. We praise Allah as He is meant to be praised, the All Merciful, the All Wise, the All Knowing, the Most Powerful, the One who causes the living thing to die and then takes the dead thing and brings it back to life, the One who sent His noble messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam with the divine message. And what was that message? La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. That there is no God who is worthy of worship except for Allah, and that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We send these salutations, we send the prayers upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whom Allah sent to us to teach us and to show us the way and to help us to see the path from darkness and bring us to the light. We ask Allah to continue to bless our noble messenger, and we ask that Allah continue to allow us to love the messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his wives and his children and his companions and everyone who follows him as a Muslim from this day until the day of judgment. After that, brothers and sisters, we pray that Allah make things easy for the Muslims. We pray that this virus, Allah protects humanity. We pray that Allah accepts from us. We pray that Allah allow us to die as Muslims, and we pray that Allah allow us to be resurrected on the Day of Judgment with the noble messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now, what have you prepared for tomorrow? I will repeat. What have you prepared for tomorrow?
وَلَا تَقُولُوا لِمَنْ يَقْتَلْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ أَمْوَاتٍ بَلْ أَحْيَاءٌ وَلَكِنْ لَا تَشْعُرُونَ ولنبلونكم بشيء من الخوف والجوع ونقص من الأموال والأنفس والثمرات وبشر الصابرين الذين إذا أصابتهم مصيبة قالوا إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون.
My dear brothers and sisters, what have you prepared for tomorrow? Allah has revealed in the Noble Quran,
واتقوا يوما ترجعون فيه إلى الله.
And fear a day, remember a day, whatever you're doing, remember there's gonna come a day when you will return back to Allah.
ثم توفى كل نفس ما كسبت.
And every soul will be paid back for what he did. Every person will be paid back for what he did. وهم لا يظلمون. And no one is going to be wrong. Allah, he says that he never wrongs mankind. إن الله لا يظلم الناس شيئا. Allah never wrongs mankind in any way. ولكن الناس أنفسهم يظلمون. But rather mankind, they wrong themselves. May Allah protect us. The hadith on the authority of Abu Hurairah, who narrated from the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who says, أَكْثِرُوا ذِكْرَ هَذِمِ اللَّذَاتِ. Remember, always remember the destroyer of pleasures. And then Abu Hurairah, he defines, what is this destroyer of the pleasures? يَعْنِ الْمَوْتِ. It is death. Here it is death. What is the one thing that separates the husband from the wife, the brother from his brother, the sister from the sister, the friend from the friend, the neighbor from the neighbor, the business partner with the business partner, the lover from the lover, the associate from the associate, the friend from the friend. The one thing, brothers and sisters, it is death. So know that no matter how much you live, no matter how long you live, what's the one thing that's promised to you after life? It's death. Because Allah promises no mercy. He told him,
إِنَّكَ مَيِّتٌ وَإِنَّهُمْ مَيِّتُونَ.
O Muhammad, those who are fighting with you about this matter, this religion of ours, إِنَّكَ مَيِّتٌ, you will die. وَإِنَّهُمْ مَيِّتُونَ, and you, they also will die. So if Allah is telling this to His noble messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that after his life is death, what about you and me, my beloved brothers and sisters? So let's remember the destroyer of pleasures. Let's remember that after the job, after the children, after the wives, after the wealth, after the houses, after the clothes, after the weddings, after the celebrations, after everything, the one thing that is going to remain is what? That is death. Allah has promised us that every soul will taste it. When He says,
كُلُّ نَفْسٍ ذَائِقَةُ الْمَوْتِ.
Every soul will taste this death. Death is like when there's a wedding and the women, they make the porridge that the, you know, Africans, we drink from it. In my language, we call it sombi. And every person, they have what we call a ladle in which they drink from the porridge, or this sombi that we call it in my native tongue. So death, consider death like that. Death is like we're all sitting around the bowl, drinking the porridge. Everyone will get a drink. Everyone will get a drink. Everyone will get a taste. Allah has a promise.
وَإِنَّمَا تُوَفَّوْنَ أُجُورَكُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ.
And you will be given your payments. I mean, remember, this world is like a job, a 9-to-5 job. When you clock out is when Allah is going to give you the payment. You don't go to the job and ask the boss for the payment up front. You work your hours and then by the end of the shift, your boss gives you the payment. So we work in the 9-to-5 shift of this dunya, and then when we die, Allah will give us the payment that we worked for. So make sure when you're working in this dunya, make sure that your work is legitimate. Make sure that you're doing a good job. May Allah protect us. So Allah says,
وَمَنْ زُحْزِهَ عَنِ النَّارِ.
So whomsoever is saved, whomsoever is taken away, drawn away from the fire,
وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةِ,
and entered into the paradise,
فَقَدْ فَازَ,
and this person has succeeded. May Allah make us the successful brothers and sisters. And Allah says,
وَمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا مَتَاعُ الْغُرُورِ.
And this worldly life, this world is nothing except enjoyment for whom? The people who are delusional. The The people who do not know about the hereafter, the people who do not know about the resurrection, Allah continues to show them good things. He continues to show them the pleasure, continues to grant them in wealth, in children, in wives, makes everything blissful for them to the point where they start to forget about the hereafter. May Allah never do that to us. Allah promises again, He says, كُلُّ نَفْسٍ ذَائِقَةُ الْمَوْتِ. Every soul shall taste death.
وَنَبْلُوكُمْ بِالشَّرِّ وَالْخَيْرِ فِتْنَةً.
And we will test you, we will test you, we will see, we will give you an examination of what? Of good and evil. Allah will test you with the good and Allah will test you with the bad, and all of this is what? A trial. So remember, brother and sister, it is nothing but a fitna. This worldly life is nothing but a fitna. And then what does Allah say after all of this, after the trials? He says, وَإِلَيْنَا تُرْجَعُونَ. And to us you will return. So we are not like the non-Muslims, the non-believers, in which they say, after death, there's nothing. In which they used to constantly ask the Prophet, إِذَا كُنَّا عِظَامًا. If we become bones, basically.
أَإِذَا مِتْنَا وَكُنَّا تُرَابًا وَعِظَامًا أَإِنَّا لَمَبْعُوثُونَ خَلْقًا جَدِيدًا.
Does this man promise us? And I'm just paraphrasing this ayah right here. Does this man promise that when we have long passed away and we have become dust, our bones have become dust, that we will be brought back again as a new creation? And did they not remember that Allah is the same one who created them the first time? If Allah created you from nothing and made you something and then made you nothing, can He not make you not again something from nothing? The answer, brothers and sisters, is yes. May Allah make it easy for us. And then Allah says again,
كُلُّ نَفْسٍ ذَائِقَةُ الْمَوْتِ.
Every soul shall taste death.
ثُمَّ إِلَيْنَا تُرْجَعُونَ.
And then afterwards, unto us they will return. May Allah make it easy for us. Allah says again in the Quran,
هُوَ يُحْيِي وَيُمِيتِ.
He is the one who gives life and He is the one who causes death.
وَإِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ.
And unto Him you will return. فَأَقُلْ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ. الحمد لله رب العالمين. May Allah grant us good actions and protect us from shaitan and allow us to remember that after all life is death. After all life is death. Now you have to ask yourself, Allah has told you that death is going to happen. There's nothing you can do to stop it. Now you have to ask yourself, so why am I alive? Why am I living? You ask the non-Muslims this, they say, life, there is no meaning. If you're looking for the meaning to life, brother, there's no meaning to life. It's just, you live, you do what you do, you die. As they like to say, they have this saying in, that they like to say, that they say you only live once. But as Muslims, we understand that that is not the truth. You live, you are dead, Allah made you alive. And then from you alive, Allah caused you to die. And then after death, Allah will raise you again a second time. May Allah make it easy for us. Allah asks us this question.
أَفَحَسِبَتُمْ أَنَّمَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ عَبَثًا.
Then, did you think that we created you for nothing? Did you think we created you for to be useless?
وَأَنَّكُمْ إِلَيْنَا لَا تُرْجَعُونَ.
And that you will not return back to us, brothers and sisters? Let's ask ourselves the question, no matter how you live, no matter how long you live, 50 years, 100 years, 900 years, Prophet Noah lived for 1,000 years, except for 50 years, amongst his people. And he, what happened after the life? Death came. How many nations came before us, people living for years? 100, 200, 300. Like I said, Noah, 950 years, or 1,000 years, basically. Without 950 years spent calling his people. And 50 years, just a regular man within his people. What happened after those 1,000 years, brother and sister? You have to ask yourself, what happened? One thing that we know happened, death, of course. If death came from the prophets and the messengers, don't you think it will come from me and you? Allah says,
وَمَا خَلَقْنَا السَّمَاءَ وَالْأَرْضَ وَمَا بَيْنَهُمَا بَاطِلًا.
And we did not create the heavens and the earth and everything in between in for nothing, in vain. And Allah says, and Allah warns us,
ذَلِكَ ظَنُّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا.
This is the thinking of the non-believers. They think this, that Allah created all of this. You ask them, why are we alive? Why is everything here? They'll tell you, no, there's no God. There's no reason for us to be here. We die and we become nothing. Allah is telling us, whoever has this type of mindset, you have the mindset of disbelief. You have a mindset of somebody who has not believed. And Allah said,
فَوَيْلٌ لِلَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنَ النَّارِ.
So woe, destruction to who? Those who disbelieve because of the fire. May Allah protect us from that. And Allah said, brothers and sisters,
وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ.
And we have not created jinn and man except to do what? To worship. May Allah make it easy for us. And remember, so now we understand, we're here for a reason. Now, the same question I asked you earlier, what have you prepared for it? Allah said in the Quran,
Inna nahnu nuhyi al-mawta.
And indeed, it is we, I'm referring back to myself, but na'udhu billah. It is we who bring the dead back to life.
وَنَكْتُبُ مَا قَدَّمُوا وَآثَارَهُمْ.
And we record, we make an account, we have it put down. What happened? What they have brought to put ahead of themselves. Because when you're in this world, when you do an action, it's not like you just do it and it's ending in the moment. You do it and then you find it ahead of you when you die. May Allah make it easy so that whatever we put in front of us is only going to be good. And that whatever we leave behind is going to be good. And Allah says,
وَنَكْتُبُ مَا قَدَّمُوا وَآثَارَهُمْ.
And what they leave behind, as Allah's mentioned.
وَكُلَّ شَيْءٍ أَحْصَيْنَاهُ فِي إِمَامٍ مُبِينٍ.
In all things, Allah says, we have calculated. We have put them together and put them in a clear register. So brothers and sisters, know, anything that we do, Allah has the account. Allah has the, like when you call the bank at the end of the month and they give you your bank transaction and you see everything that you did, everything that you put your money into, Allah will do the same thing for you on the Day of Judgment. He will bring you out. He will bring out the news and show you everything. And everything will be on the statement and you cannot deny it. May Allah protect us from that day. So Allah gives us another question, brothers and sisters. This is why we say Quran is the key to worship. Quran is the key to becoming a better Muslim. Because how can you build a connection with Allah without the Quran? Allah says,
Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu.
O you who believe,
ittaqullah.
Be conscious of Allah. Whatever you're doing, remember Allah.
وَلْتَنْظُرْ نَفْسٌ مَا قَدَّمَتْ لِغَدْ.
And every soul, every person, every man, every woman should look to do what? What they have put ahead of them. What have you put that you will find in front of you on the Day of Judgment? May Allah protect us. What have you put ahead of you for tomorrow? What have you prepared for tomorrow?
وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهُ.
And see, Allah says in the same verse twice, and fear Allah.
Inna Allah khabirun bima ta'amanun.
And fear Allah. Indeed, Allah is all aware of what you do. May Allah make things easy for us, brothers and sisters. So why did I bring this topic up today? Why did I decide today we'll talk about death, talk about returning, talk about the Creator? For those of you that don't know, we lost one of our beloved Shaykh, Muhammad Yatabari. And wallahi, for those of you that know him, knows that he was somebody who spent his life dedicated towards giving knowledge, towards teaching knowledge. So you'll find so many people in this masjid alone, they have learned from this Shaykh at one point. Even before I was born, I found a lot of my uncles, my father's friends learning from him. I came into the world, they were still learning from him. I grew up, became a teenager, they're still learning from him. I went back home to memorize Quran, came back, people are still learning from him. In fact, about three Ramadans ago, I was standing with him right here in the first supper, every night of Ramadan that year. I believe it was either 2017 or 2018. So no, brothers and sisters, that person that you're praying with, you may see them today, but you won't see them tomorrow. So what will that person leave behind? What did our beloved Sheikh leave behind? He's the beloved uncle of our Imam Musa Zaidwage, and we ask Allah to bless him and make it easy for his family. Because one thing we understand is whatever hurts your teacher, it hurts you too. Whatever sadness your teacher feels, wallahi, you feel it too. So may Allah make it easy for him and make it easy for us. So our beloved Sheikh Muhammad Yatabari, Allah, he was a person, he dedicated his life towards teaching Islam. And what did Allah, what the Noble Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam say about this type of person? أن أبي هريرة on the authority of Bukhari رضي الله عنه أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم that the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم قال, he said, إذا مات الإنسان, when mankind dies, when a man dies, انقطع عنه عمله, his deeds stop, his good actions, they stop, everything he does, they stop, إلا من ثلاث, except for three things. And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentions these three things. إِلَّا مِن صَدَقَةٍ جَارِيَةٍ, except for the one who gives sadaqah that is continuous for him. You build a masjid. You fund people who are learning the Qur'an. You build centers for people who are homeless. You build a well for the people who don't have something. You build a foundation where people can be given food that don't have food. You build some type of foundation where people who are not able to learn the Qur'an, now they're able to learn the Qur'an. Brothers and sisters, let's do this. If we have time to build houses, we have time to buy houses, we have time to buy cars, then we should have time to invest in our akhirah. May Allah make it easy. Allah, and then the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أو علم ينتفع به, or knowledge that he spread that people are benefiting from it. Because knowledge is continuous. You know, they have a saying, they have this thing that they love to say. You teach somebody, you give somebody a fish, you only feed him for a day. You teach somebody how to fish, you feed him for his entire life. May Allah make it easy for us. So spreading knowledge, this is something our beloved Sheikh did. How many people are here today that learned from this Sheikh? And how many will continue to teach others? And now we pray that Allah puts all of this into his mizan on the Day of Judgment. So that last thing that the Prophet ﷺ said, أَوْ وَلَدٍ صَالِحْ يَدْعُوا لَهُ, or a righteous child that makes dua for the parents. May Allah grant us righteous children that will make dua for us. So this was the legacy of the Shaykh. So we ask Allah to grant him Jannah, and we ask Allah to forgive him. And you have to ask yourself, this is what he left behind. He left behind knowledge of the deen, knowledge of Allah, knowledge of the Messenger. Now ask yourself, when you die, when I die, what will you and I leave behind? What will you and I leave behind? Remember that. The next time somebody gives you something and tells you to sell something that is haram. Or next time somebody sends you, oh, I want to become a rapper. I want to do music. Share my music. Tell people about me. Tell people that I make good music. Remember that the next time you do that. Remember that the next time something haram is going on in whatever location, and you invite people there, like, yo, let's get together. Let's go do this haram thing. May Allah make it easy for us. This was the Shaykh's legacy. He prepared his akhirah with knowledge. We ask Allah to make it easy for us also to gain knowledge and to spread the knowledge so that we can find it ahead of us. And the last thing, brothers and sisters, I will mention, because time, we are pressed for time. You did what you did, yes. You disobeyed Allah, yes. You sinned, yes. You transgressed against Allah, yes. You transgressed against yourself, yes. But does this mean that you are doomed? Does this mean that you are destroyed? The answer is no, brothers and sisters. Because what does Allah tell us oftentimes in the Quran? قل, O Muhammad, say to them, يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَصْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ. Say, O my slaves, O my servants, the ones who have transgressed themselves with sin, the ones who have committed sin over and over and over and over and over again, لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله. Do not give up hope in the mercy of Allah. إن الله يغفر الذنوب جميعا. Allah forgives all sins. إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. Verily, He is the most merciful. He is the most forgiving, the most merciful. May Allah grant us forgiveness and grant us mercy. Last thing I'll mention, again, you have wronged yourself, you have sinned. You can repent and decide that, okay, today I want to prepare something for the next life. Allah says, إِلَّا مَن تَابَ وَآمَنَ وَعَمِلَ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا. Except for those who repent and they believe and they do good deeds, that they will find ahead of themselves. They prepare for themselves good deeds, that they will find a day of judgment. فَأُولَٰئِكَ يُبَدِّلُ اللَّهُ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ حَسَنَاتٍ. Then Allah says, for them, Allah will take their evil deeds and He will place it and turn it into good deeds. May Allah make it easy for us.
وَكَانَ اللَّهُ غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا.
And Allah is indeed the most forgiving, the most merciful. And Allah said,
وَمَنْ تَابَ.
And whomsoever repents,
وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا.
And he does good deeds, prepares for the hereafter.
فَإِنَّهُ يَتُوبُ إِلَى اللَّهِ مَتَابًا.
And whomsoever repents, and they do good deeds, and they decide, I want to prepare for the next life, subhanAllah.
فَإِنَّهُ يَتُوبُ إِلَى اللَّهِ مَتَابًا.
And does indeed return to Allah in repentance. May Allah make it easy for us. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. ربنا إنك جامع الناس ليوم لا ريب فيه إن الله لا يخلف الميعاد. اللهم اغفر له وارحمه وعافه واعف عنه وأكرم نزله ووسع مدخله واغسله بالماء والثلج والبرد ونقه من الذنوب والخطايا كما ينقى الثوب الأبيض من الدنس. وأبدله دارا خيرا من داري وأهلا خيرا من أهلي وزوجا خيرا من زوجي وأدخله الجنة وأعزه من عذاب القبر ومن عذاب النار. اللهم إني عبيدك بنو عبيدك بنو عمائك نواصينا بيدك ماض فينا حكمك عدل فينا قضاؤك. نسألك بكل اسم هو لك سميت به نفسك أو أنزلته في كتابك أو علمته أحدا من خلقك أو استعثرت به في علم الغيب عندك أن تجعل القرآن العظيم ربيع قلوبنا ونور صدورنا وجلاء أحزاننا ذهاب همومنا وغمومنا مسارقنا وقعدنا إلى رضوانك وجنتك وجنة النعيم. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. قوموا إلى صلاتكم يا عباد الله.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
استووا واعتدلوا وتراصوا. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. الرحمن علم القرآن خلق الإنسان علمه البيان الشمس والقمر بحسبان والنجم والشجر يسجدان والسماء رفعها ووضع الميزان ألا تطغوا في الميزان
وَأَقِيمُوا الْوَزْنَ بِالْقِسْطِ وَلَا تُخْسِرُوا الْمِيزَانَ وَالْأَرْضَ وَضَعَهَا لِلْأَنَامِ فِيهَا فَاكِهَةٌ وَالنَّخْلُ ذَاتُ الْأَكْمَامِ والحب ذو العصف والريحان فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم